Hello everybody, I am Rushikesh Patil from ACTREC Tata Memorial Center, India. ACTREC is a comprehensive center for research and treatment of cancer patients in our country. Today, I am glad to present my PhD work done at ACTREC on exploring the pro-tumor role of IL-17 producing gamma delta T cells in gallbladder cancer. Inflammation is an important characteristic of a cancer. It associates with initiation, progression, and metastasis of cancer. Considering this fact, inflammation is included as one of the important hallmarks of cancer. However, how the tumor-infiltrating immune cells regulate inflammation and cancer progression is poorly understood. Gallbladder cancer is an interesting model to understand this crosstalk of immune cells, inflammation, and cancer. Basically, gallbladder cancer is an adenocarcinoma. It is more prevalent in northern part of India compared to rest of the world. The major risk factor of gallbladder cancer is cholelithiasis, in other words, gallstone disease. More than 70% of gallbladder cancer patients are associated with cholelithiasis. It is hypothesized that chronic persistence of gallstones in gallbladder cause trauma and chronic inflammation, which leads to dysplasia, carcinoma in situ, and invasive carcinoma. To evaluate the pro-inflammatory immune cells in the tumor environment of gallbladder cancer, we used multicolor flow cytometry approach and investigated the IL-17 and IFN gamma producing cells. We observed that CD4 positive T cells producing IL-17, that is Th17 cells, were elevated in the peripheral blood of gallbladder cancer patients. The Th17 cells were further increased in the tumor compartment of gallbladder cancer patients. Next, Tc17 cells were also elevated in the peripheral blood and tumor environment of gallbladder cancer patients. Next, when we analyzed gamma delta T cells, we observed that gamma delta T cells also produce IL-17 and were significantly increased in the peripheral blood and tumor environment of gallbladder cancer patients. As an interest, further we focused on gamma delta T cells, as gamma delta T cells is an interesting subtype of CD3 T cells, which is different from alpha beta T cells. Gamma delta T cells express gamma and delta chain in their TCR and recognize antigens different from alpha beta T cells. Gamma delta T cells recognize phosphoantigens, for example, intermediates of mevalonate pathway. Mevalonate pathway is a cholesterol biosynthesis pathway overexpressed in tumor cells. In response to these phosphoantigens, activated gamma delta T cells show cytotoxic activity and kill the tumor targets. Such cytotoxic activity of gamma delta T cells against different cancers is previously reported by our lab. We have also shown that gamma delta T cells require NOT signaling for their effector functions. It is reported that gamma delta T cells show antitumor activity by secreting perforin and granzymes, by ADCC, by secreting IFN gamma and TNF alpha. They also mediate apoptosis through FAS-L signaling. Based on these antitumor properties of gamma delta T cells, they are considered as potential candidate for adaptive T cell therapy. Interestingly, when we analyze this antitumor phenotype of gamma delta T cells, that is IFN gamma producing gamma delta T cells, they were significantly decreased in the peripheral blood and tumor environment of gallbladder cancer patients. CD8 positive IFN gamma positive cells were also showed similar trend. and Th1 cells also did not show any change. Further, when we analyze total IL-17 producing cells in the tumor compartment of gallbladder cancer patients, we observed that gamma delta T cells were increased in the total IL-17 producing cells in the tumor environment compared to peripheral blood. But CD4 T cells showed opposite trend. They decreased in the tumor compartment compared to peripheral blood. Thus, the data suggests that gamma delta T cells have higher propensity to produce IL-17 in the tumor environment compared to CD4 T cells. Next, we investigated the cytokines required for T gamma delta 17 differentiation. We found that the levels of IL-17 were significantly elevated in the sera of gallbladder cancer patients. Similarly, IL-8, which is secreted in response to IL-17, is also elevated. We found that levels of IFN gamma decreased in the sera of the patients. The levels of IL-6, IL-1 beta and IL-23, which are known that required for differentiation of gamma delta T cells to produce IL-17, were increased in the sera of the patients. Thus, the data suggests that the environment in the peripheral blood supports T gamma delta 17 differentiation in gallbladder cancer patients. Next, when we analyzed anti-inflammatory cytokines, we observed that the levels of IL-10 did not show any change, but the levels of TGF-beta were significantly decreased. Since TGF-beta required for differentiation of regulatory T cells, and we found that TGF-beta decreased in the sera of the patient, we analyzed regulatory T cells in gallbladder cancer patients. By analyzing CD25 positive, CD127 negative and FOXP3 expressing cells in CD4 positive T cells. We found that the levels of Treg cells characterized as CD4 positive, CD25 positive, CD127 low expressing FOXP3 were decreased in the peripheral blood of GBC patients. But the tumor infiltrating Treg cells were increased compared to peripheral blood of patients, but were comparable to the Treg cells in healthy individuals. Further, the levels of FOXP3, the transcription factor of regulatory T cells, which is associated with their suppressive function, did not show any change among peripheral blood of patients and healthy individuals, but their levels were increased in the tumor infiltrating regulatory T cells. Next, to evaluate whether the suppressive function of regulatory T cells was impaired, we isolated regulatory T cells from patients and co-cultured them with non-Treg cells in mixed lymphocyte reaction. The proliferation of non-Treg cells was monitored by CFSE dye dilution assay. We observed that as the regulatory T cells were increased in the co-culture, the proliferation of non-Treg cells was decreased. Moreover, the suppressive potential of regulatory T cells from patient was comparable to that of healthy individuals. Thus, the data suggests that although Treg cells were decreased in the peripheral blood of patients, their suppressive potential was not compromised. Next, we analyzed the dynamics of immune cells with cancer stage of the patients. Around 60% of the patients were in stage 4 and around 30% were in stage 3. The levels of T gamma delta 17 were significantly high in GBC patients with any stage compared to healthy individuals. There was no specific trend observed with stage of the patients. Similar pattern was also shown by Th17 and Tc17 cells. In case of regulatory T cells, the levels of Treg cells showed slight increasing trend, but the levels of regulatory T cells were lower than healthy individuals. Thus, the data suggests that although Treg cells present in the tumor environment, the immune response is skewed towards IL-17 producing cells in GBC patients. To investigate the clinical relevance of this skewed immune response in GBC patients, we studied the survival analysis of these patients. We categorized the patients into two groups, having high and low levels of Tγδ17 cells in peripheral blood. It was observed that the patients with high levels of Tγδ17 cells were associated with poor survival, whereas the patients with low levels of Tγδ17 cells survived longer. In contrast, the patients with high levels of gamma delta positive IFN gamma positive cells survived longer compared to the patients with low levels of gamma delta positive IFN gamma positive cells. This suggests that the T gamma delta phenotype promote cancer progression. Further, the serum IL-17 levels were also associated with poor survival of GBC patients, whereas patients with high IFN gamma survived longer. Th17 and regulatory T cells were also associated with poor survival of GBC patients. The data clearly suggests that the levels which observed in the peripheral blood of the patients associates with the survival of these patients. Next, to investigate the mechanism of function of Tγδ17 cells, we asked a question whether Tγδ17 cells migrate towards tumor environment. To answer that, we studied chemokine receptors on the surface of Tγδ17, Th17 and Tc17 cells. We studied different chemokine receptors such as CCR6, CCR7, CCR4, CXCR4 and CXCR3. We observed that the expression of chemokine receptors on Tγδ17, Th17 and Tc17 were comparable in patients and healthy individuals. Further, when we specifically analyzed the expression of CXCR3, we observed that the expression of CXCR3 was significantly elevated specifically on Tγδ17 compared to Th17 and Tc17. We thought that Tγδ17 might be using CXCR3 chemokine axis for their migration. Thus, to investigate that the Tγδ17 migration use CXCR3 chemokine axis, first we purified the Tγδ17 cells from peripheral blood of healthy individual and cultured them in a transwell assay, where Tγδ17 were cultured in the upper chamber and the gallbladder cancer cells were cultured in the lower chamber. We observed that the Tγδ17 migrated to the lower chamber in response to gallbladder cancer cell line or ligand for CXCR3, that is CXCL9, as well as in response to supernatant of surgically resected tumor tissue. This migration was abrogated in presence of blocking antibody for CXCR3. This proves that Tγδ17 cells migrate towards tumor environment through CXCR3, CXCL9 chemokine axis. We have also investigated the presence of these chemokines in the tumor supernatant of freshly resected tumor tissue and in the sera of the patients. Further, we studied the cytokine profile of purified Tγδ17 cells and shown that Tγδ17 majorly produce IL-17 but not IFN gamma. We also studied the expression of IL-17 receptor on the surface of gallbladder cancer tumor cells by flow cytometry and confocal microscopy. Next, we studied the effect of Tγδ17 cells on the gallbladder tumor cells We collected cell-free supernatant of Tγδ17 cells and cultured with gallbladder cancer cell line OCUG1. In presence of supernatant, the levels of VEGF were significantly increased, which were abrogated in presence of blocking antibody for IL-17. Further, we studied the other angiogenesis markers using angiogenesis array. In presence of Tγδ17 supernatant, gallbladder tumor cells secreted various angiogenesis inducers such as VEGF, UPA, MMP9, GM-CSF, coagulation factor 3, angiogenin, etc., which were abrogated in presence of anti-IL-17 antibody. Thus, the data suggests that Tγδ17 induced angiogenesis in gallbladder tumor cells through interleukin-17. The pro-angiogenic function of Tγδ17 cells was further confirmed by Chick chorioallantoic membrane assay. The supernatant of Tγδ17 cells was added onto the CAM of 5-day-old fertilized chicken eggs, and blood vessel formation and branching points were monitored. In presence of Tγδ17 supernatant, the number of blood vessels and branching points were significantly increased, which was reduced in presence of blocking IL-17 antibody. Thus, the data suggests that Tγδ17 is a pro-angiogenic subtype of gamma-delta T cells. Since Tγδ17 shown its effector functions through IL-17, we studied the effect of IL-17 on gallbladder tumor cells. We observed that IL-17 induced VEGF production in gallbladder cancer cells in concentration-dependent manner. It also induced the proliferation of gallbladder cancer cells. Next, we studied the migration of gallbladder cancer cells by wound healing assay. After 21 hours of culture in the presence of IL-17, gallbladder cancer cells showed enhanced rate of wound closure. Similar effects were also observed on another gallbladder cancer cell line, that is NODS. Further, the invasive potential of gallbladder cancer cells were studied using matrigel coated transpel inserts. The number of GBC cells invaded through matrigel upon treatment with IL-17 were increased significantly compared to medium alone. Similar trend was also shown by another cell line, that is NOD cell line. This shows that IL-17 promote proliferation, migration and invasion of gallbladder cancer cells. Thus, in summary, we have shown that pro-inflammatory environment of gallbladder cancer promote the differentiation of Tγδ17 and Th17 cells. The IL-17 secreted by Tγδ17 cells induce angiogenesis, proliferation, migration and invasion of tumor cells. The CXCL9 secreted by the tumor cells recruits Tγδ17 cells through CXCL9-CXCR3 axis. Similarly, regulatory T cells present in the tumor environment suppress the antitumor CD8 IFN gamma and gamma delta IFN gamma cells and thereby support the tumor immune evasion. Thus, in conclusion, our data provide evidence for the first time that human Tγδ17 is a pro-angiogenic subtype of gamma delta T cells. Tγδ17 and Th17 act as predictive markers in gallbladder cancer. Tγδ17 mediated angiogenesis and regulatory T cells mediated immunosuppression may contribute to the negative clinical outcome which is observed in gallbladder cancer patients. Thus, considering the findings of this study, the future immunotherapeutic treatment may consist of blocking the trafficking of Tγδ17 cells to the tumor, inhibiting the functions of IL-17 and reversing the immunosuppression mediated by regulatory T cells. At the end, I would like to acknowledge my mentor, Professor S.V. Chipundkar, for her constant support. I acknowledge my clinical collaborators, Dr. Rajesh Dikshit, Shailesh Shrikhande and Mahesh Goyal from Tata Memorial Hospital, Mumbai. I also thank my funding source as Department of Biotechnology, Center of Excellence Grant, Government of India for their generous funding. I thank DIE ACTREC for providing the fellowship. Last but not the least, all gallbladder cancer patients and healthy volunteers for their precious samples. Thank you.